morning children, welcome back to online classes. Dear children, how are you? I hope you are all good. Children, in this pandemic situation, the best thing is stay home and stay safe. Wear masks and use sanitizer whenever you go outside. Dear children, before going to our class, let me introduce myself. I am Lata, working as CRT English in KGBV Dachepalli, Guntur district. Children, today I want to teach you 9th class unit 2 A reading true height summary. Before going to the summary of this lesson true height, let us remember some points about our previous session. What had happened in our previous session? In our previous session, we discussed about the theme of unit 2. Unit 2. The theme of this unit 2 is games and sports. The theme of this unit 2 is games and sports. We saw the difference between games and sports. Games conducted in a big auditorium and sports conducted in Olympiad. Games are cricket, hockey, volleyball. And sports are running, swimming, long jump, high jump, javelin throw. Children, I hope you are all understood very well the difference between games and sports. And now let us see the summary of our lesson true height. Before going to our lesson, here we have a beautiful quotation. All of you see that.
Dream, dream, and dream high, for dreams lead to thoughts and thoughts lead to actions. This means if you don't dream big, then you can't do something big for you. The dream is the only thing which can encourage you every day to do some big for yourself and also for others.
Now, dear children, this story talks about an athlete as he pursues his dream. Let us see the summary of this lesson, true height. The athlete name is Michael Stone. Michael Stone was a blind man who had a dream of flying. He wanted to become a pole vaulter to fulfill his dream. Pole vaulting is truly the glamorous event of any track and field of competition. The sportsman has to combine the grace of a gymnast with the strength of a bodybuilder. Pole vaulting has the element of flying. The thought of flying as high as a two-storied building is a mere fantasy to anyone watching such an event. Michael had drawn inspiration from his mother. She used to tell him numerous stories about flying as he was growing up. She used to describe the landscapes from a bird's eye view. They were very fascinating for the young Michael. Her excitement and passion for details made Michael's dreams full of color and beauty. He had this recurring dream of flying over the beautiful landscapes. He could feel the rocks and chunks of dirt at his feet while he was running down a country road. As he raced down the golden wheat fields, he would always outrun the locomotives passing by. He would begin soaring like an eagle. She also advised him to be a relaxed and free-dreaming boy. She used to tell him to take deep breaths when he felt tense or scared. Betstone, his father, was not a dreamer. He was a hardcore realist. He believed hard work and sweat. His motto was, if you want something, work for it. Michael did a very systematic practice in weightlifting and running. This program was carefully monitored by his father, who was also his coach. Michael showed a lot of dedication, determination, and discipline. Besides being an honest student, he used to help his parents in farm tasks. He also strove hard with obsession and passion for perfection. Michael cleared at 17 feet 2 inches and 17 feet 4 inches in his first two trial jumps. He wanted to win the first place. So, in the final jump, he cleared 17 feet 6 and a half inches. He not only won the National Junior Olympics but also set the new national and international Olympic record. He was delighted at a smile on his mother's face. His father, Bert Stone, could not control his emotions and hugged his wife and cried. He shed the tears of pride. The people hugged him and congratulated him heartily on the greatest accomplishment of his life. It was not because he had just increased his personal best by 9.5 inches. It was because he was blind.
And this is the summary of our lesson, True Height. Now, children, I hope you all are understood very well about the summary. Let us see some important points about Michael Stone. Michael Stone, his father name is Bert Stone. Michael Stone's father name is Bert Stone. He is a hardcore realist. He believes hard work and sweat. His motto is, if you want something, work for it. Whereas his mother name is Mildred Stone, and she told numerous stories about flying when Michael was a child. Michael is a pole vaulter. He cleared the bar at 17 feet 2 inches and 17 feet 4 inches. Later he cleared at 17 feet 6 and a half inches, a national and international Olympic record. He created a national and international Olympic record. All the people are congratulated him because Michael was a disabled person. His disability is he is a blind man.
True Height. Michael Stone was a blind man who had a dream of flying. He wanted to become a pole vaulter to fulfill his dream. Pole vaulting is truly a glamour event of any track and field competition. The sportsman has to combine the grace of a gymnast with the strength of a bodybuilder. It also has the element of flying. Pole vault, a sport in which you use a long pole to swing over a high barrier. Michael's mother was a good motivator. Her stories had a great impact on Michael since his childhood. She told him a number of stories about flying. As he was growing up, she described the land from a bird's eye view. Her excitement and passion for details made Michael's dreams full of color and beauty. Bird's eye view, view of all the aspects of something. He developed passion and love for flying. She was very suggestive and encouraging. She always advised him to be relaxed and be like a free dreaming little boy. His mother used to tell him to take deep breaths when he felt tense, anxious, or even scared. On the other hand, Michael's father, Bert Stone, was not a dreamer. He was a hardcore realist. He believes in hard work and sweat. On the other hand, Michael's father, Bert Stone, was not a dreamer. He was a hardcore realist. He believes in hard work and sweat. His motto was, if you want something, work for it. The program was carefully monitored by his father, who was also his coach. Hardcore, strong, a saying that express aims and beliefs of a person. Michael drew inspiration from his mother to dream about his future and set a goal, and his father made him work hard to realize that dream. So both these approaches had helped him pull off his dream. Michael did a very systematic practice in weightlifting and running. He showed a lot of dedication, determination, and discipline. Michael worked hard from the age of 14. He began a very careful and regimented weightlifting program. He worked out every other day with weights and did running on alternative days. Constant preparation and determination were his vision. Regimented, strict and organized. It was a tense moment for Michael Stone. The intensity of the movement filled his mind with anxiety. His palms were sweating. His mind needed a towel to dry his grip. He began shaking off the tension from his body. He became more tense and nervous because it was the day which was going to make his dream come true. Michael cleared the bar at 17 feet and 4 inches in his first two trial jumps. He wanted to win the first place. So in the final jump, he cleared 17 feet 6 and a half inches. He not only won the National Junior Olympic record, he was delighted at a smile on his mother's face. His father, Bert Stone, could not control his emotions and hugged his wife and cried. He shed the tears of pride.
Dear children, I hope you all are understood very well the summary of this lesson through height by seeing this video. Now I'll ask some questions regarding this lesson through height. The first question is, what was Michael Stone's dream? What was Michael Stone's dream? Michael Stone's dream was to fly high. Michael Stone's dream was to fly high. Michael Stone's dream was to fly high. What was the name of Michael's father? What was the name of Michael's father? Michael's father name was Bert Stone. Michael's father name was Bert Stone. Who was his coach? Who was Michael's coach? His father was his coach. His father was his coach. Fourth question. Who was Mildred Stone? Who was Mildred Stone? Michael's mother. Yes, you are correct. Mildred Stone was Michael's mother. Mildred Stone was Michael's mother. Michael's mother. What was Michael Stone's dream? Michael Stone's dream was to fly high. What is the name of Michael's father? Michael's father name was Bert Stone. And who was his coach? His father was his coach. Who was Mildred Stone? Mildred Stone was Michael's mother. What was the surprising thing about Michael? What was the surprising thing, students? Yes, Michael was a blind man. He was a disabled person. In which event Michael win the National Junior Olympics? In which event? In Which event Michael won? In which event Michael won the National Junior Olympics? The National Junior Olympics. In which event Michael won the National Junior Olympics? Pole vaulting. The event is pole vaulting. Pole vaulting. The event is pole vaulting. What was Michael's aim? What was Michael's aim? What was Michael's aim? Michael's aim was to come first. Michael's aim was to come first in pole vault at Olympic Games. In pole vault at Olympic Games. At Olympic Games. What was the surprising thing about Michael? What was the surprising thing? Michael was a blind man. In which event Michael win National Junior Olympics? Pole vaulting. The event name is pole vaulting. What was Michael's aim? Michael's aim was to come first in pole vault at Olympic Games. And what was the challenging event? What was the challenging event? What was the challenging event? What was the challenging event mentioned here? The event is a pole vault competition. Pole vault competition. The event is pole vault competition. What was Michael's stone? What was Michael's stone? What was Michael's stone? Michael's stone. What was Michael's stone? Michael's stone was a pole vaulter. Michael's stone was a pole vaulter. Michael's stone was a pole vaulter. What was the competition he was facing? What was the competition? What was the competition he was facing? He was facing. What was the National Junior Olympics? National Junior Olympics. National Junior Olympics. What was the challenging event? What was the challenging event? Pole vault competition was the challenging event. What was Michael's stone? Michael Stone was a pole vaulter. What was the competition he was facing? He was facing National Junior Olympics.
Now let us see the glossary of this unit. This is AstroTurf. AstroTurf means
a type of artificial grass surface used especially for sports grounds. Pole vault, a sport in which you use a long pole to swing over a high barrier. A bird's eye view of all the aspects of something. Hardcore, strong. Motto is saying that express aims and beliefs of a person. Regimented, strict and organized. Obsession, a state in which a person's mind is completely filled with a thought of one particular thing. Obvious, here obvious is an adjective. Not aware of something or unaware. Ritual, any customary observance or practice. Fingertip, the tip of fingers touching the ground. Envision, have a vision of somebody or something. Runway, running track. Here, runway means running track. And sprinting down. Running very fast. Swamped with, surrounded by. And now children, let us see vocabulary. Vocabulary synonyms. Steadfastness. mess continuity. Ceaselessness, steadfastness, continuity. L-Y is suffix, the new word is quickly. Next, friend. New word is friend. Friend is a word. Suffix is a ship. And the new word is friendship. 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 Freedom. Free. Free. Freedom. Free is a word. Dom, D-O-M, is a letter or a group of letters. Use a new word. These are suffixes. Invention, invent. Another word is invent. I-O-N, invention, I-A. Invention. A suffix is a letter or a group of letters which is added to the end of a word. A suffix is a letter or a group of letters which is added to the end of a word to make a new word. Quick is a word, L-Y is suffix, and the new word is quickly. Friend is a word, ship is a suffix, friendship is new word. And free is a word, dumb, suffix freedom. Invent, I-O-N, suffix invention. And we have prefixes also. Students, we have prefixes. Let us know what is about a prefix. Prefix. Here we saw about suffix and what is a prefix. What is a prefix? Prefix. A prefix is a word or a letter or a number placed before a word to make a new word. Prefix is a word or a letter or a number placed before a word, to make a new word, Suffix is added to the end of a word and prefix is placed before a word. Suffix is added to the end of a word. Added to the end of a word. And prefix is placed before a word. Placed before a word. For example, agree. 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 Prefix this. Prefix placed before a word. And the new word is disagree. 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 Legal. IL. Prefix is IL. And the new word is illegal. Illegal. Mid. Night. Prefix is mid. Night. Word. And the new word is midnight. understood the difference between suffixes and prefixes. Suffix means the word or a letter which added to the end of a word. Which added to the end of a word to make a new word. Which added to the end of a word. And prefix is which placed before a word. The suffix is added end of the word and prefix is before a, placed before a word. Let us see the examples of suffixes and prefixes. Prefix. Agree. Pre means the word which placed before the word and use new word. Disagree. Legal. IL. Illegal. Might. Need. New word is midnight. And day. Prefix is midday. Midday. Right. Word is right. Prefix is re. And new word is rewrite. Rewrite. Next, suffix. Suffix. The word which ends, which added to the end of a word. Quick is a word. Ly is suffix. New word is quickly. Quickly. And invent. Invent. I-O-N. Invention. Free. Dumb. Freedom. New word is freedom. Friend. Ship is a prefix and the new word is friendship. Friendship. High. Suffix is ness and the new word is highness. These are prefixes, the word which is placed before the word and gives a new word. These are suffixes, the letter or group of letters which added the end of a letter. And children, I hope you all understood the difference between prefixes and suffixes. Here we have some examples about suffixes. Computation. Here suffix is ion. A new word is completion. Second one is excitement. Excitement. Suffix is ment. New word management. Persistency. Suffix ence and new word is consistency. immediately. Suffix here, suffix is ly. New word immensely. Wonderful. Suffix ful. A new word is graceful. Effortless. Suffix less. New word restless. These are our textual examples in page number 31. Page number 31. These are our textual examples. Suffix means the word or letters which add the end of a word and gives a new word. And prefix placed before a word. Suffix added end of a letter, prefix added placed before a word. Students, I hope you all understood very well about suffixes and the difference between suffixes and prefixes.